Glitches and hazards. Let's say you have designed a combinational circuit which has different paths with different delays. What it means is the delay of all the paths from input to output is not same. In this case, the circuit might produce some unwanted switching transitions at the output, and we call these switching transitions as glitches. So, a hazard is said to exist when the circuit produces such a glitch. And we can classify these hazards into static 1 hazard, static 0 hazard, and dynamic hazard. Now let's look at one by one. Static 1 hazard. We expect the output to be stable 1, but unexpectedly 0 glitch appears. It's called static 1 hazard. Static 0 hazard. We expect the output to be stable 0, but unexpectedly 1 glitch appears. Dynamic hazard, we expect the output to change from 1 to 0 or 0 to 1, but it changes more than once. It's called dynamic hazard. Now let's see how to avoid these hazards. You have the circuit. Look at here. There are various paths, A to F, B to F, C to F. If you calculate the propagation delay, A to F, 4 nanosecond, B to F, 4 nanosecond, but C to F is only 2 nanosecond. So what we do is, we add buffers. So this way, we try to equalize the delays. Now, if you calculate the propagation delay of C to F, 1 plus 1 plus 2, 4 nanosecond. So this way, you can avoid the switching transitions. And another way, while minimizing the terms, you have the logic function. You group ones like this, and you can also create the redundant term grouping ones like this. Look at here, the AC is the redundant term, right? This way, you can avoid the glitch. So here, this is the gate for AC. All right, okay. And what else you can do? You can register the output. Look at the circuit. Here, F is the output. Because of the difference in delays, you get these glitches at the output. There are some glitches. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to register this output using a flip-flop. Now, the flip-flop is going to sample the output only at the clock edge. Look at here. It's going to sample the output only at the clock edge, and it's going to produce the stable output like this. So, obviously, it's going to discard all these glitches. This is how you can eliminate these hazards. Thank you.